There's a question from the audience, which is a question directed at me. What are some of the positive insights from the latest Arbute survey in regards to digitization post-COVID? How quickly is the MENA region adapting to digital transformation? Thank you for that question. I think there's been a trend that we've been looking at, not just because of the pandemic, but over the last nearly 12 years that we've done the survey. And I can tell you, and just to give you some numbers, when you look at social media usage for consumption of news, 2015, there was only 25% of our sample across the region that used social media in 2015. In 2020, that's gone up to 79%. Now look at that dramatic change in just about 6 years. And when you look at young Arabs are turning to smartphones to watch videos, for example, you know, 62% use, not surprisingly, smartphone to use all of their news consumption rather than television. And of course, when you look at subscribing to video streaming services, jumped up dramatically from almost zero about 5-6 years ago to 53% now. And music streaming services, even more dramatic, 62% of Arab youth across 17 Arab nations. And this is the age group of 18 to 24 use music streaming services. I'm sure Angami is doing really well because of that. And when you look at e-commerce trends, I think in 2018, 53% used e-commerce, and in 2020 jumped up to 80%, of course, because of the pandemic. So those are a couple of trends, but you know, there's some very interesting and positive, which you should spend some time on, which is gender equality. Young women in the Arab world across the Gulf, Levant and North Africa feel they have equal rights to men, nearly 67% of the sample. I think this was one of the brightest findings that we had this year, actually. And a lot of young people are also saying that that religion plays too much of a role in public life, and they want religious institutions to reform. Now, these are voice. We call this report Voice for Change. You can get this report on our ArabYouthSurvey.com website. So thank you for asking that question. That's from Elias Jabbe. Of course, yes.